I think any good morning show teaches you something. Why should this show be any different? Today I'm going to teach you how to win any argument. You just got to not fuck up.
Table block where we got tables and we got blocks. The more blocks you play with, the more chances you get to win free beer. So come on down to table block, table and blocks. We don't even know what it's called.
I used to live in a very messy apartment, and I know that because I'm the one who made it messy. But I had a roommate that would retaliate. And rather than come at me and say, hey man, you got to pull your weight around here, I need you to clean up a little bit more, he would just have sex with my girlfriend, which is what we used to call listening to TV loud, real loud in the other room. So then I would obviously get mad at him for doing that. Now you have an argument that goes back and forth forever. He fucked up. All you got to do is not fuck up, because eventually I would have had to acknowledge my ways and change my ways for the betterment of our relationship and for the overall state of our apartment. Instead, what we got was this back and forth, hey, you need to clean, hey, you had sex with my girlfriend, back and forth. But if he never did that, who knows what could have happened? We could have saved our friendship. We could have had a more attractive apartment. We could have been having sex with my girlfriend together. You know what I mean? Or do you not know what I mean? Now, since we got one of these fun themed episodes going, I asked you for arguments that you've been having, and I'll solve them for you. Not a problem. I have some time on my hands. Also, I thought this would be so much fun because I love hearing other people's arguments, because I know that they're not my fault. I'll weigh in on your shit all day. Tatiana Audra Lexen, someone with a very royal name, and so many of them, says, should I swear at my cat? So her sister says you shouldn't swear at the cat because the cat will know that you're upset, and she swears at her cat, and she thinks it's funny, and here's my two cents. I think that's hilarious. I will come over and also swear at your cat. From what I read, cats pick up more on your voice and your scent and your touch rather than how you look and like cues, because we don't process emotions in the same way. So your cat will know that you're pissed off at it, which is fine if you got a shitty cat, because otherwise how would you know? Also, if the cat picks up on your tone of voice, if you just swear at it in a different voice, it won't know who the fuck's talking to it anyway. Fuck you, mittens. I swore at a bunny once, and you know bunnies don't understand shit about humans. Why would they? We're so much different than bunnies. And I pointed at it and I said, fuck you. It doesn't sound like much, and I'm sure you're not laughing where you're at, but in person, that was, I laughed for a long time. Plus, your cat doesn't give a shit. You do whatever you want. Your cat doesn't care at all. Might as well say a couple of your favorite words. Argument number two, Lexi loves chaos. My grandmother doesn't like the word fart and would prefer that we say pass gas. My mom thinks it's hilarious. Never stop saying fart. Maybe don't say fart around your grandma until her hearing completely goes. What a sad day. You can't enjoy anything about farts once your hearing completely goes, right? No one likes farts for the smell. Everybody knows that. And did you know that farts are made by the opening to your anus and not your butt cheeks flapping together? I had to read that, which means somebody, a doctor, had to type that out. You know, just so you know, farts aren't made by your butt cheeks flapping together. That was the terminology. I wasn't reading like Grey's Anatomy, but that's what the article said. The internet, that's what the internet said. I looked up the background for the word fart, and there was this one article that said the word fart and its puzzling heritage. Looks like no one knew who dealt it. Google says it's from the Old English fjorting. So maybe try that out around grandma. Passing gas is way more syllables than farting. Is she just trying to prolong the conversation? And finally, argument number three, Emily Buck says, is it worth it to make your bed even though you're just going to sleep in it again? Yes, absolutely. Is it worth it to flush your toilet just because you're going to make Duke in it again? Yes. Some things you just got to do. I talked on this other podcast called Whiskey Ginger with Andrew Santino recently about how dope it is to keep a clean house. I did not keep a clean house for most of my young adult man life until I moved in with a lady who would have it no different. You clean the house before you go away, even if it's just for a weekend, and you come back and the whole fucking house is clean and your shit is made. It's like coming back to a hotel. Hotel it on the mountain. That is the best way to live your life, and it helps your head and your mental state. Dude, never make your bed and tell me that you're just as relaxed at night when you get into it. Doubt it. I doubt it. What's a morning without coffee? Dumb. This is One Sip Review.
Y'all, I don't want to go naming names or nothing, but this right here is a Kenyan pour over from Rival Brothers. Now I can drink that one till the cows come home. Now I ain't sure what you heard, but this is One Sip Review, so it is a bit of a tradition around these parts, and we take the second sip. So this one starts off sweet, then it does get kind of bitter towards the back there. Overall, I'd recommend it, and you City Slickers, have a good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us today on Mike in the Morning. I hope that you take this into your everyday life and you never lose a goddamn argument again. And that is my hope for you, and that is my hope for your Christmas. And also, I hope that you watch Making Friends on Christmas Eve or soon thereafter. It's a free stand-up thing that I have coming out on Christmas Eve on my YouTube channel. You're going to see a bunch of names pop up on the screen right now. These are sponsors of the channel. These people believe in what we're doing here, and they give a little bit of money every month, $5 to be exact, and they get 5 extra things. If you'd like to be part of that, you can hit the join button down below. If you just want to keep watching this shit for free, just hit subscribe, and then hit the bell, and then hit the bell over and over again. That's how you make it ding little man. It all makes sense. I think that's all I got for today. I had a great time with you. Check out the DFTBA store if you'd like. Check out the Dynamic Banter podcast. And for the love of gosh, that's what Goofy used to say, come see me do stand-up live. Coming to so many places, Portland, all over Los Angeles at all times. And there's a list of all those dates on MikeFalzone.com. All the time. All right. Have a happy morning. Love you.